Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Although we cannot be together in the same place, that does not minimize the importance of celebrating the graduation of the 2020 Doctor of Pharmacy class at the University of Texas at Austin College of Pharmacy. With this ceremony, we celebrate the accomplishments of 113 student pharmacists who have fulfilled all academic requirements for the Doctor of Pharmacy degree, along with four additional student pharmacists who anticipate fulfilling all academic requirements for their degree and graduating in August. We celebrate as graduates, we celebrate as family and friends, and we celebrate as faculty and staff of the college. I refer you to the graduation convocation program that is available on the UT College of Pharmacy website for detailed information regarding today's graduation celebration.
Thank you, Dean Crisman, for making this virtual celebration possible. I want to welcome friends, family, faculty, and fellow graduates. I am deeply honored to speak on behalf of the 2020 graduates of the University of Texas at Austin College of Pharmacy. Now, I'll try to be brief so everyone can get back to their Zoom parties and their TikTok videos, but I understand if you feel the need to put me on 2x speed. I do want to apologize for the formal attire. With all of the sheltering in place, my cow pattern pants are still at the cleaners. Now, as a Longhorn, I can think of two of the most sacred events you can participate in. The first is singing the Eyes of Texas following a victory in Cotton Bowl Stadium. But the greatest is walking across that platform, or in our case, rolling your slide across the screen in true millennial fashion, nevertheless, as a graduate of the University of Texas at Austin College of Pharmacy. Now, first, I want to thank all of the deans, faculty, and staff. You are undoubtedly the reason we are the number one pharmacy school in the great state of Texas. And on behalf of the class of 2020, I would also like to personally recognize and thank Dean Ridings Myra and Dr. Seltzer. They worked tirelessly and went above and beyond to ensure all of us had the opportunity to complete our final rotations during this global whirlwind. Likewise, we are forever grateful to all of the faculty, preceptors, and rotation sites that made this a possibility for all of us. I am deeply thankful to my preceptors, John Gass and Gloria Stone, for their dedication and creativity that led to my fulfilling rotation experiences despite heavy restrictions with COVID-19. I'm immensely thankful for my beautiful wife, Stephanie. Without her support, this dream would have never come to fruition. In addition, I owe my inspiration and motivation to my sister, Claire, and my son, Eli. Now, parents, I want you to think back midway through our curriculum when we were wowing you over the holidays with our newfound vocabulary and knowledge. Enter Aunt Sally with the sniffles. Aunt Sally, it sounds like you have seasonal rhinitis secondary to type 1 hypersensitivity. Aunt Sally, that sounds serious. Am I going to be all right? You'll be fine. I'll make sure that you get oral cetirizine and fluticasone nasal encephalations daily. Well, now, parents, we have come full circle and learned how to say it in Texan. Yep, you got the cedar fever. You'll be right as rain just after I fix you up with some allergy meds. I am also proud to say that the class of 2020 is a dynamic group. Our class boasts students from all over the globe in all walks of life. Our group offers incredible perspective. Most of my classmates holding prior degrees, some even including PhD, law, nursing, and as we graduate from this program, that diversity continues. Some of us have already accepted offers presented through internships and rotations. Others have committed to residencies and fellowships, and some are continuing their academic journey to pursue PhDs. Regardless of your path, I admonish all of you to remember why we are truly here. No matter how we practice pharmacy, our purpose is to serve our patients. You may be designing clinical trials. You could be preparing technetium 99 for radiodiagnostics, or you could be counseling a patient on her first asthma inhaler. Our oath is ultimately the same. We are dedicated to the welfare and relief of suffering for our patients, both those we have met and those we may never encounter. Also, never forget what it means to be a graduate of this program. It is a high honor. And moving forward, we continue to represent this university. Wear it well. Now, as I was brainstorming ideas for what to talk about today, I took some time to reflect on all the things that I will miss. I will miss taking the long way through campus just so I can pass the turtle pond and the tower. I will miss the smell and beauty of the mountain laurels in full bloom across the 40 acres in the early spring. I will also miss free subscriptions to LexiComp, UpToDate, and Micromedics, which are set to expire in July, so make sure you find a new password soon. I will also miss breaking out motivational interviewing and the change ruler at every possible occasion. And I already miss seeing all of your faces and the reactions as you listen to my dad jokes. Now, class of 2020, let's go out there and change the world. Hook 'em.
Hey, class of 2020. Wow, you did it. I'm so proud of you.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. Welcome to the profession.
Can't wait to see the amazing impact you'll have on the world. Hook 'em.
I'm so proud of all of you.
You did the hard work, and we got you to the starting line. Now it's go time.
I'm really happy for you. Almost like I'm on Prozac, which you remember has a secondary meme that can get endemethylated, which is still active.
You are the first I've ever gotten to work with from the beginning of P1 through the end of P4.
You overcame a lot of challenges at the end of your pharmacy school tenure. You overcame. I'm proud of you.
Has it really been 4 years since you went through the admissions process? Wow, time flies.
And remember, you are and will always be a member of the College of Pharmacy family.
I'm very happy for you and proud of you. Thanks for letting us be a part of your lives for the past 4 years. I wish you all the best.
I want to wish you the best of luck moving forward in your career. Hook 'em horns.
Congratulations. We will miss you. Hook 'em horns.
We're so proud of you. Now go get them. Hook 'em horns.
A special shout out to all my research mentees.
Celebrate with your friends, family, and loved ones.
You did it. I wish you all the best.
Go off and do great things. Change the health of the world. One person, one patient at a time. Just saying. Hook 'em.
Hello, my name is Sandra Leal, and I'm the Executive Vice President for SinfoniaRx. I am also the President-elect of the American Pharmacists Association. I want to thank Dr. Lynn Chrisman for the invitation to celebrate such a joyous occasion with you today. It has been an honor to work with your program over the last couple of years as one of our clinical sites, and it's a real pleasure to be here. Unfortunately, we can't be here in person, but I am so grateful that we're together no matter what the barriers are. And this is what I want to reflect on today. Celebrating this occasion is really incredible. And as I'm stepping into the role of president of the American Pharmacists Association in the coming year, I've really had an opportunity to reflect on the platform that I'm going to be speaking about and taking on as I move forward. There are so many things that I'm passionate about. And I remember that I had a lot of thoughts in my head when I was sitting in the chair, just as you are today for graduation. One of the things that keeps on rising to the top for me as I think back and as I think forward is that about mission. A mission statement really defines what an organization is, why it exists, what the reason for being is. And a lot of my career, as I've reflected on the choices I've made, have really been to try to align with the mission of the organization. And that takes me to who I am as a person. And hopefully it helps you reflect as you're thinking about your own future today. What is that mission for you? Why do you exist? And what is your reason for being? Why did you become a pharmacist? The professional and personal fulfillments that I have achieved in my life have come from one thing, from my parents and what they've always taught me. And it's really to find what you care the most about, what your mission is, what your passion is, and what you are doing to make a better future for you and for those around you. My parents were immigrants, and I was the first person to go to college in my family. They actually came here to the United States to make a better life for me, for my family, and to really create new opportunities. When I reflect back on that sacrifice that my father and my mother made, it really takes me back to why I became a pharmacist. Now what I do is I really try to think about how I want to contribute to legacy. A lot of what I do is not so much about, you know, trying to do something for a job, but really about what impact I can have and what I can do to help others. And that's really why I truly became a pharmacist. Some of the platforms I have taken on take me back to why I really want to help people that have a lot of issues, underserved populations, advocating for the most disadvantaged, and being an access point for people who are really struggling in challenging times. And this, the moment that we're facing right now, is an example of that. The profession has really stepped up, and we've been a really great source of advocacy for people that are really struggling. So you're really stepping into that role now as you lead today to help and to be part of that team. One of my favorite quotes is that individually we are one drop, but together we are an ocean. So you leave today as a single pharmacist, but together you join a profession where we can really make and create a support network that's incredible to help people have better access and better outcomes. I encourage you to stay involved, to advocate for yourselves, to advocate for the contributions that you make to the care team, and all along the way that you will find professional satisfaction that spills into your personal and to your professional life. And that's really what it's all about. Hopefully you picked a profession that makes you happy. And there will be barriers along the way. There always are. But it's not about the barrier itself, but it's about the moment that you're living. And it's about overcoming the barriers that make it worth a fight. Thank you again for the opportunity to celebrate this day with you. And I hope we actually get to see each other and meet each other in person. I hope that you're able to attend APhA next year when I take the platform and I talk about our profession and where we're going. And I really hope that you become one of the future leaders of our profession. Thank you.
In a world disrupted by COVID-19, it became apparent several weeks ago that we would not be able to celebrate with you in person on the UT Austin campus as you graduate from the University of Texas at Austin College of Pharmacy. But it got me to thinking about 4 short years ago. It was a hot day in August, and you walked across the stage in the Texas Union Ballroom and received your white coat, a symbol of our profession, and it marked the beginning of your journey towards your PharmD degree. Well, today, you would have had a very similar ceremony, but instead of that white coat, you would have received a doctoral hood. The hood that signifies the ending of that journey and the completion of your PharmD degree. And it would be just about that time in the ceremony that you would be anxiously walking to the stage in Bass Concert Hall, waiting to hear your name called, walking across the stage, receiving the hood, and shaking hands with the dean. So PharmD class of 2020, today, along with your family and friends, we celebrate you. And we congratulate you on 4 years of incredible accomplishments and hard work. Congratulations. Best of luck. Hook 'em horns. And light the tower orange.
Dr. Ashley Abraham. Dr. Jancy Danae Addison. Dr. Michael Kasandu Akwari. Dr. Itzel Alfaro Rivas. Dr. Brooke Elizabeth Allison. Dr. Danielle Michelle Alvarez. Dr. Brenda Astorga. Dr. Courtney Jewel Bowes. Dr. Seth Michael Beltran. Dr. Christine Elizabeth Barunda. Dr. Eldridge Darnell Boyce, Jr. Dr. Claire Teresa Brandt. Dr. Gladys Brown. Dr. Alex Daniel Cantu. Dr. Patrice Annette Carmouche. Dr. Judy Hua Hua Chan. Dr. Jia Yun Choi. Dr. Cassandra Klossner. Dr. Kayla Klossner. Dr. Elena Michelle Coleman. Dr. Mitchell D. Crouch. Dr. Richard George Crowell. Dr. Kristen Elizabeth Curry. Dr. Cassandra A. De La Garza. Dr. Maria Fernanda Delgado. Dr. Ashley Thuy Nhi Dinh. Dr. Kelly Nicole Dursk. Dr. Omar Alejandro Fuentes. Dr. Jessica Ariana Galindo. Dr. Roberto Javier Galindo. Dr. Ravi Karan Gandhi. Dr. Lisa Garcia. Dr. Kevin Yang. Dr. David Vu Yang. Dr. William Randolph Godinez. Dr. Ann Jeanette Gonzalez. Dr. Kyle Andrew Gordon. Dr. Shelley Goyal. Dr. Chelsea Michelle Griffin. Dr. Megan Ha. Dr. Diana Marcella Hess. Dr. Samantha Marie Hill Keen. Dr. James Sue. Dr. Ashley Nasima Ibrahim. Dr. Dariush Ilgari. Dr. Emily Jane Interante. Dr. Christopher Brian Jackson. Dr. Valanda Sheridith Jackson. Dr. Annie K. Jivan. Dr. Alieshka Lise Husino Acosta. Dr. Lenny Elsa Kirikot. Dr. Caitlin Eva Kennedy. Dr. Rubia Michelle Khalid. Dr. Hannah Kim. Dr. Nikita Sunny Kutiani. Dr. Chia Xuan Kuo. Dr. Caitlin Elizabeth LeBay. Dr. Faluk Lalani. Dr. Thais Yvonne Lael. Dr. Andrew Kang Lee. Dr. Andres Alberto Leos. Dr. Lindsay Jordan Loera. Dr. Jordan Mackenzie Loomis. Dr. Daisy Annette Madrigal. Dr. Yana Nicole Maskov. Dr. Elizabeth Ann Mesadas. Dr. Matthew John Moore. Dr. Eva Marie Moore. Dr. Robert Anthony Moten. Dr. Dr. Hannah Taylor Muka. Dr. Kenny Nguyen. Dr. Quinn Ni T. Nguyen. Dr. Jessica Jolene Ochoa. Dr. Joel Ariel Orendine. Dr. Linda Elise Palacios. Dr. Rupesh M. Panchal. Dr. Taylor Marie Patek. Dr. Nicole Marie Peterson. Dr. Jaime Abraham Pena. Dr. Kariana Susuel Pena. Dr. Chiam Anh T. Pham. Dr. Sarah Marie Pistilli. Dr. Natasha Hassan Paremji. Dr. Julio Quintanilla. Dr. Ravina Sunil Rana. Dr. Mandy Lynn Renfro. Dr. Erin Diane Ressweber. Dr. Jessica Lynn Robertson. Dr. Cameron Elsid Roy. Dr. Sarvnaz Sadramelli. Dr. Kevin Robert Salinas. Dr. Brittany Allison Santos. Dr. Savita Sentil. Dr. Min Young Sun. Dr. Ryan Michael Edward Shaw. Dr. Yevgenia M. Shinkar. Dr. Mariela Itzel Silva. Dr. Hannah Ray Spector. Dr. Stephen D. Swank. Dr. Dr. Stephen Ambrose Thompson. Dr. Dorothy Joy Tran. Dr. Megan Mecki Tran. Dr. Michelle Tran. Dr. Vu Mi Thuy Tran. Dr. Ryan Ung. Dr. Brandon Matthew Varghese. Dr. Laurency Vizcaino. Dr. Victoria Mai Tao Vong. Dr. Stephen Hong Wang. Dr. Melissa Naku Weller. Dr. Patrick Mackenzie Whaley. Dr. Ashley Heather Wolf. Dr. Stephen Douglas Wolf. Dr. Pedro F. Yabar. Dr. Alexander Gregory Yap. Dr. Jessica Yee. Dr. Chen Yuan Zhou.
Graduates, please join your faculty, administration, and classmates for a few special moments together as we reflect on and then recite the Oath of a Pharmacist. The Oath of a Pharmacist articulates a special covenant into which we enter with our patients and with society at large that recognizes the unique and important role that we play as pharmacists in the care of the citizens of our communities. Not only does it speak to our professional responsibilities, but it also embodies the concept of serving others as an extraordinary privilege. Perhaps you remember that during our white coat ceremony on your first day at the college, we recited this oath together. Although the oath is always at the heart of your practice, its true meaning has never been more apparent nor more poignant as it is now during these times of great uncertainty yet unwavering commitment on the part of pharmacists and other healthcare providers. It is most fitting then that we send you off reminding you of this same conviction, which has carried you through pharmacy school and will hopefully remain with you for the rest of your professional lives. I promise to devote myself to a lifetime of service to others through the profession of pharmacy. In fulfilling this vow, I will consider the welfare of humanity and relief of suffering my primary concerns. I will apply my knowledge, experience, and skills to the best of my ability to assure optimal outcomes for my patients. I will respect and protect all personal and health information entrusted to me. I will accept the lifelong obligation to improve my professional knowledge and competence. I will hold myself and my colleagues to the highest principles of our profession's moral, ethical, and legal conduct. I will embrace and advocate changes that improve patient care. I will utilize my knowledge, skills, experiences, and values to prepare the next generation of pharmacists. I take these vows voluntarily with the full realization of the responsibility with which I am entrusted by the public. Congratulations.
Class of 2020, congratulations, you made it. Despite all of the adversity that you experienced this year, you've shone through it all. We are so incredibly proud of you. Now it's time for you to go out and change the world. Congratulations again, and hook 'em.
Hey, class of 2020, we miss you guys so much, but we are so proud of you for persevering and completing your degree.
I wish you all the best and can't wait to see how you make your mark on our profession.
From your Longhorn faculty family to each and every one of you, I wish you all of life's best wishes for success in your new pharmacy careers.
2020 graduates, you've worked hard and you should be proud to be part of the profession that's healing the world. Go Longhorns!
I think that going through all this together will give you a special bond for the future, and I hope to see you at the face-to-face commencement. Congratulations again.
And welcome to the alumni family. Hook 'em.
Graduates, I know that each of you has looked forward to this day for the past 4 years. This is not how you or your faculty intended your student pharmacist career to conclude. Frankly, it is not how I intended to celebrate my last year and last graduation as Dean of the College. During the past 2.5 months, you've experienced a great deal of stress. Rotation sites were suddenly changed for many of you, as was the method in which you developed your practice competencies. Throughout this period, our goal has been for you to be able to complete the requirements for your Doctor of Pharmacy degree in as safe as a manner possible and be able to graduate as scheduled. Albeit stressful, I maintain that you learned a lot as a result of this experience. Although this has certainly been different, life is filled with disruptions, twists and turns, disappointments, and intermittent crises. The COVID pandemic forced you and all of us to be flexible, adaptable, and face change with little notice. Pharmacy leaders advise me that the ability to change, be adaptable, and lead change are attributes they seek in hiring pharmacists regardless of the work setting. You have proven that you can face a crisis, adapt and change, and persevere to the finish line. Congratulations. Typically, I talk about finding one's passion at graduation. And you may recall me discussing that topic at New Student Orientation 4 years ago. However, today I would like to briefly discuss a different concept. I will frame it with a short story. A few years ago, I had the opportunity to see Jim Collins speak. Collins, author of such books as Good to Great and Built to Last, is widely regarded as one of the leading authorities on the characteristics of successful companies and nonprofit organizations in the Western world. He shared a story of having the opportunity, when he was in his early 30s, to spend a day with Peter Drucker. Drucker, 49 years older than Collins, is considered by many to be the father of modern business management. About halfway through their day together, Drucker told Collins that he could tell that something was troubling him and asked what it was. Collins indicated that he was having trouble deciding what to do next in order to make himself successful. Drucker replied, "The goal is not to be successful, but to make yourself useful." This story has stuck with me, and I often reflect on it because that I think it is so true. In fact, it may be truer at this time in our lives than at any other time that I can remember. When I see what pharmacists, physicians, nurses, and other essential health workers are doing during the COVID pandemic, it is obvious that they have taken up Drucker's charge to be useful. Healthcare clinicians place themselves at potential risk in order to support the health and the lives of others. That is what pharmacists do as health professionals, and it makes them true heroes. Today, you join your colleague pharmacist in implementing pharmacy's mission to help people achieve optimal health outcomes and in quest of our profession's vision that medication use will be optimal, safe, and effective for all people all the time. Regardless of the path that you pursue during your career, I hope that you will remember Drucker's charge: make yourself useful. Instead of trying to convince administrators, physicians, and nurses of the advanced services that you would like to provide as a pharmacist, instead try asking, "What can I do to help you improve the care of patients? What can I do to help you make lives better? What can I do to make this a better organization?" To your patients, please ask, "Can I do anything to help you improve your health and well-being? Can I do anything to help you with your medications? What can I do to help assure that you obtain the best outcomes for your medications?" You may be surprised at the reaction that you will receive when you ask what you can do to be useful rather than what you think that you need to do in order to be successful. In fact, making oneself useful is at the very core of being a servant leader. Remember that your time spent here at UT is merely preparation for a life course of continued learning and professional development. There is a world of difference between 20 years of experience and 1 year of experience 20 times. Which will you choose? I encourage you to follow a path in life that will allow you to look back along the trail and say that it was a path worth following, and that in some way the world is a better place as a result of you having passed that way. Search for a path that represents the highest of life's ideals and allows you to lead a useful life. Search for it, wherever it may be, wherever you may find it, wherever it may lead. And once you find that path, follow it, step by step by step. Graduates, you did not arrive at this day alone. You have parents, spouses, companions, children and grandparents, brothers and sisters, and special friends who supported you along the way. When you can do it safely, give them a big hug, thanks and recognition for having played a significant role in your life and in allowing you to reach this important milestone. You pursued your pharmacy education at the University of Texas because you wanted to attend one of the premier colleges of pharmacy and learn from and be mentored by an outstanding faculty. Similarly, dedicated staff support our faculty as well as our student pharmacists. When you have the opportunity, I hope that you will thank your faculty, staff, and preceptors for teaching you and assisting in your professional development. Graduates, it is important that you recognize another group of supporters. Your fellow UT graduate pharmacists are now also members of your family. Your classmates, who were strangers to you just a few years ago, have seen you at your best and perhaps at your worst, and they have stood by you. Over the last few years, they have anguished with you as you experienced setbacks and disappointments and celebrated with you the victories and successes. You share memories that will bind you together for a lifetime. Continue to interact with your classmates through friendship, through pharmacy practice, and through active participation in pharmacy's professional organizations. You and your classmates joined nearly 9,000 other UT Pharmacy alumni as part of the UT Pharmacy Longhorn family. Network with other Longhorn pharmacists wherever your profession takes you. As a gift, the college has purchased you a one-year membership in the Texas Exes. Become active in the Exes, and particularly in the UT College of Pharmacy Alumni Association. Stay connected with your college. Come back and see us. Be active in the college's educational programs. Become a preceptor. Advocate for pharmacy. Advocate for quality patient care and for the University of Texas. Remember those who came before you and provided the support for scholarships that you may have received, for support of student organizations and attending professional meetings, for support of community service projects, and for all of our college's programs. You will be richer for this effort, and both pharmacy and society will benefit from you having contributed to the education of future pharmacists. As we conclude this ceremony, do not think you are leaving the University of Texas at Austin. It is now a part of each of you as you are a part of one another. You will always be a UT Longhorn and a graduate of the University of Texas College of Pharmacy. Go out into the world, uplifted by your immediate family, as well as your Longhorn family, ever remembering that indeed, what starts here changes the world. We will end this celebration the way we end all important events at the University of Texas College of Pharmacy by singing the Eyes of Texas, the alma mater of the University of Texas at Austin. Hook 'em horns.